Merrill, there be whales here.
It was special effects technician Clay Pinney's job to create these whales, affectionately named George and Gracie.
In Star Trek IV, when we were researching the whales, because we were going to have to construct a full-size humpback, we went to the Cetacean Society, got a bunch of information from them. I believe it's the Ferraras from Hawaii who do a lot of underwater filming of the humpbacks. We got tapes from them, and we were working with ILM and the footage they had because they were creating the four-foot miniature whales that worked. So basically it was studying that, seeing what the movement was, getting a skeletal breakdown of the fish. Once we had the shape and the body parts, then it was finding some way mechanically that we could duplicate the actions of that. I think in Star Trek IV, when we were filming both the Cetacean Society building and the storm with the bird of prey, that was all done in the miniature tank at Paramount. And we had a severe restriction there because we had a, I believe it was about a 15 by 20 foot pit that was 10 feet deep. The rest of it was all 54 inches of water.
For Pinney and his visual effects crew, these were some of the most challenging scenes in the movie. Not only did they have to create lifelike animatronic whales, but a section of track had to be built to transport the whales.
So what we did was we made the track endless from both sides. We brought the humpback in one way when you're filming, looking at the Cetacean Institute, brought it in the other way, reversed the camera, and did the other scene with the storm and the bird of prey. We rehearsed that about five or six times, shot it five or six times each way, and put it away. We had a trolley station, we'd bring the whale up and out, recharge the hydraulics, put it back in and run it. Again, just real careful preparation and planning, and we shot that very quickly and efficiently.